السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. So today we shall discuss the virtues of the 10 days of the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. The first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah are the best days, but especially its daytimes. Best times for good deeds, for doing good deeds for a Muslim. Then, the day, ninth day, Arafah. You know, the day, ninth day of Dhul Hijjah is Arafah day. There, in Arafah, all the Muslims who went for Hajj, all the Hajjis, assembled there together from the different parts of the world. Muslims came there for Hajj. Then Arafah, the World Muslim Conference, which is the important, a prominent part of the Hajj. Prophet said, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, Al-Hajj Arafah. Hajj is Arafah. Hajj is Arafah means, Arafah is the prominent, the most important part of the Hajj. All Muslims gather together there in the Arafah Maidan. Okay. There. So the unity of the Muslim Ummah, unity of humanity is there. It's expressed there. Okay. You know, Jama'at Namaz or Salah in Jama'at, in congregation, is 27 times better than Salah, when performing Salah alone, single, alone. So, there also unity is there. So, stress is given to unity, or unity among the Muslims, among the Muslim brothers. Okay. In Friday, on Friday days, so for every in every week there is Friday, there is one Friday, and one Friday all Muslims of a locality, a mahal, jama'at, will assemble together in the masjid. Then they pray together. So in 1 year, all Muslims from different parts of the world, of different languages, of different colors, of different nations, they assembled together. Labbaik Allahumma labbaik. Say, they will be saying labbaik Allahumma labbaik. So on that day, the Arafah day, the day time, so among the day times of the whole year, the Arafah day is the most virtuous day, most virtuous day. And among the nights, the night of Laylatul Qadr, which falls in the Ramadan month, you know, it is the best night. So the best day is the day of Arafah, and the best night is the day or the night of Qadr. Yes, say Qadr, Laylatul Qadr, night of Tikri, night of Qadr. Okay, so the Arafah day, during the Arafah day, the Haji is performing Hajj. So they are doing Hajj. They are assembling there. It is a part of Hajj. Okay. And for them, there is no sunnat, no fasting. But for others who do not perform Hajj on that in that year, they should perform, they should fast. And it is sunnat mu'akkada. It is, though it is not compulsory, it is a mu'akkad sunnat, confirmed sunnat, strong sunnat, okay, mustahab. It is mustahab for other Muslims in all parts of the world to fast. So, in harmony with the Hajjis, okay. Then, fasting from first of Dhul Hijjah itself is sunnah. So there are many hadiths regarding this, and not only fasting, all other amal, all other deeds during the day times, especially during the day times. No. The proofs. Riyadus Salihin, Imam An-Nawawi. One hadith is there under Kitab al-Fadail, the book of virtues, the book of virtues. Under that kitab, Bab Fadli Sawm wa Ghairihi fil Ashril Awwal min Dhil Hijjah, regarding the virtues of fasting and doing other deeds during the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. وعن ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ما من أيام العمل الصالح فيها أحب إلى الله من هذه الأيام يغني أيام الأشر قالوا يا رسول الله ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله قال ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله إلا رجل خرج بنفسه وماله فلم يرجع من ذلك بشيء رواه البخاري ابن عباس رضي الله عنه سج قال حسد قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم the messenger of Allah رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سج ما من أيام العمل الصالح فيها أحب إلى الله من هذه الأيام it is there are no days during which the righteous deeds or good actions is so pleasing to Allah than these days. So these days, these 10 days, good deeds are more pleasing to Allah than doing other, than those of other days. Okay, then. Yagni, so ayam means here, yagni. It means, it denotes ayam al-ashr, the 10 days, the 10 days. That is the 10 days, the first 10 days of the Hijjah. قال قالوا then they said so hearing these words of Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم the Sahaba the companions of the Prophet asked him يا رسول الله O messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله and even the jihad in the cause of Allah jihad in the cause of Allah even that is not better than this deeds even Jihad is not better than this. Okay? Then, jihad means what? Striving in the cause of Allah. Striving for Islam. Striving in the cause of Allah. There are three types of jihad. One, afdalul jihad is the jihad against oneself. It is the jihad striving against the evils or shaitaniyat in our own self. Okay? That is the best part of jihad. The best jihad. Then second type of jihad is the jihad against the striving or all actions against all types of social evils. It is the second type of jihad. Then the third type of jihad is qital. That is, it is taking up arms or in Malayalam we say saayita parata. Defending Islam. That is, for against the enemies of Islam. So those who invade Islam. Those who attack Islam or those who attack a Muslim country, then that Muslim country will not be keeping silent. That the soldiers will be attacking or defending Islam, defending Islam, and they will attack the enemies. So that is called qital. That is one part of the jihad. So for defense purpose, war or attack, physical attack. Is essential and it is permitted in Islam. So here we live in a secular country. Here no qital is permitted. So here we can also or Muslims also can observe, propagate and practice their faith. Our faith. We can propagate our faith. Here we have freedom. Others also have freedom. Okay. So then we are not permitted to do qital against the people of other faith. So if it is a Muslim country, then there also non-Muslims have freedom to practice their faith. Then if non-Muslims or the enemies of Islam of their country or any other country attack the Muslims or attack the Muslim country, then they can defend, they must defend Islam. They must attack the enemies, okay, the invaders. Okay, so That is called a qital. So, wala jihad fi sabilillah, even the jihad in the cause of Allah, illa rajulun, then Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, wala jihad fi sabilillah, even that jihad in the cause of Allah is not better than the good deeds of these days, the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. Illa rajulun, except a man, a person, kharaja bi nafsihi wa malihi, he set out in the cause of Allah with his own self, with his life, with his nafs, and with his property, with his camels, or with his horses, with his property. فَلَمْ يَرْجِعْ مِنْ ذَٰلِكَ بِشَيْءٍ, then he didn't return with both of it. That is, he died in the cause of Allah. He martyred. He became a shaheed. Then for that person will get better reward than this person. Who do good deeds during the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. So, in all other cases, the good deeds of the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah are better. Okay. Now, the explanation given for this hadith in Dalil al-Falihin on Kitab. First, regarding the sanad, then Yamani, he intends for ayam. By ayam, the words ayam, yawm means day. Ayam means days or day times. Both meanings are there. Days or day times. Okay. So here Yagni, he intends. Ibn Abbas say, reporting this hadith. He intends. I and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Bi ayam, bil ayam. Al masharu ilayha ayamul ashur ay min dhil hijja. Ayam means here ashur. Ayamul ashur, the 10 days. Wal fajr in surah. Wal fajr, we know. Wal fajr.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والفجر وليال النشر والشفع
والفجر by the dawn وليال النشر and the 10 days the 10 nights so there most of the mufassirin say the interpreters they say ليال النشر means the 10 nights of Dhul Hijjah. The first 10 nights, the 10, Walayalin Ashur, the 10 nights of Dhul Hijjah. Walayalin Ashur, Wal Fajr, Walayalin Ashur. So here, the 10 days mentioned. Okay. So for both days and nights, there is importance. So especially for the days. Okay. Then. No, here are the words. Illa rajulun kharaja bi nafsihi wa malihi falam yarji' min dhalika bi shay. Except in the case of one goes forth with his life and his property and does not return with both. That means he accepts the good deeds of a person who set out in the cause of Allah and his life and was in danger and he lost his property. He lost his life, he lost his property. Okay. And his good deeds will be rewarded more. Okay. Then, it means, if a person set out for the cause of Allah in jihad with the intention of conquering the enemy of Islam, it is kharaja yaqsudu qahra aduwihi walau adda dhalika ila qatri nafsihi wa dhahab malihi falam yarji' min dhalika bi shay' ay bi anna razaqahu Allah ash-shahada. It is Allah. It means if a person set out for the cause of Allah in jihad with the intention of conquering the enemy, his intention was to conquer the enemy of Islam. Then, and during the process, he lost his life and property. That is, he martyred. He became a shaheed. Such a person will be rewarded more than a person who do good deeds during the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. Now, wali abi awana illa man la yarju bi nafsihi wala malihi وله من طريق آخر إلا أن لا يرجع وله أيضا إلا من أقر جواده وأهرق دمه. In the report of Abu Awana we see the words إلا من لا يرجع بنفسه ولا ماله, except a person who didn't return with his life and property. In another report it is that إلا أن لا يرجع, except the person who didn't return. Who didn't return means who died in the cause of Allah, who martyred in the cause of Allah, became a shaheed. So he didn't return means he died in the war. Okay, he martyred. Or illa man, in another report it is that illa man aqara jawaduhu uhri qadamuhu, except the person who lost his horse and shed his blood in the cause of Allah. That means he martyred, he became a shaheed. Now in the hadith of Ibn Umar radiyallahu anhu, who recorded by Ibn Awana, there it is. فَأَكْثِرُوا فِيهِنَّ مِنَ التَّهْلِيلِ وَالتَّكْبِيرِ فَإِنَّ صِيَامَ يَوْمٍ مِّنْهَا يَعْضِلِ صِيَامَ سَنَةً وَالْعَمَلُ فِيهَا بِسَبْعْمِيَةِ ضِعْفٍ. That is, in that report it is that فَأَكْثِرُوا فِيهِنَّ, then you should increase مِنَ التَّهْلِيلِ on those days you should increase what? Tahleel. Tahleel means say
La
ilaha illallah. There is no ilah, no one, none deserves to be worshipped except Allah. That is tahleel. What takbir? Saying Allahu Akbar. Allah is the greatest. Okay. And so you should say La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, more and more in those days. These days we are passing through this list. Okay. Ayyam al-Ashur. Okay. Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah. We have to read it more and more. We have to say it more and more, this list. Okay. What is it?
Allahu Akbar,
La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. Say.
Subhanallah,
alhamdulillah,
la ilaha illallah,
yes. Allahu
Akbar.
Because for one day's fasting of it is equals to, or it is equivalent to 1 year's fasting. Fasting 1 day among those days. It is the first 9 days. The 10th day, you know, it is Eidul Adha. It is Eidul Adha. Then it is haram or prohibited to fast on those days, on that day. Then the succeeding days, that is the following days of Ayyamut Tashriq, Dhul Hajj, 11th, 12th, and 13th. So 10th, 11th, 12th, and 13th, those days, the fasting is strictly prohibited. Okay, then from 1 to 9, fasting is there. Sunnah fasting is there. So, and 1 to 9, one fasting is equivalent to 1 year's fasting. So, how much reward we will get? MashaAllah. Inshallah. Then, وَالْعَمَلُ فِيهَا بِسَبْعْمِيَةِ مِئَةِ ضِعْفٍ. And one good deed, one virtue, one good deed will get the reward, or it is equivalent to sabu'miyat means
700.
Sabu means 7. Miyat means 100. Sabu'miyat, 700. Lilf times. It is 700 times equivalent. Then. وَلِدْ تَرْمُضِيَ أَنَّ أَبِي هُرَيْرَى يَغْدِرُ السِّيَامَ كُلِّ يَوْمٍ مِّنْهَا بِالسِّيَامِ سَنَةً وَقِيَامِ كُلِّ لَيْلَةٍ مِّنْهَا بِقِيَامِ لَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ. In Tirmidhi's report, one hadith of Abu Huraira, he said, يَغْدِرُ السِّيَامَ كُلِّ يَوْمٍ مِّنْهَا بِالسِّيَامِ سَنَةً. One day's fasting equal to
one year's
fasting. And one night's qiyam. During night time, it is qiyam. Okay, no fasting. Night time, no fasting. Day time, fasting. Okay, so one night's qiyam, that is performing salah, sunnah salah, more and more. Then one night's qiyam is equivalent to the qiyam of Laylatul Qadr, the night of decree, which falls in the month of ليله القدر in the month of
رمضان.
Yes. No. The other of دليل الفالحين quotes the following hadith in the end. أفضل الصيام بعد شهر رمضان شهر الله المحرم. So regarding the virtue or the superiority, the virtues of فضائل of أعمال, there will be varying reports. So when we read about Salah, sometimes we may feel that it's the best deed. So then when we read about Saum, we may feel that, what it is the best deed. So regarding Dhul Hijj, Ramadan, all are like that. Okay. So here we will be encouraged to do good deeds more and more on all months or days. So or some or other type of virtue will be there. So our intention, we should keep our intention good. So we see, for every Friday there is a good time, there is best time, which is the best suitor for ijabat, for dua. Then Allah will accept our dua. So all Fridays like that, all nights there is a time. So if we want to work to get the reward from Allah, there are chances, more and more chances are there. Only we should get ready. We should get ready for that, for doing the amal. We have short span of life only. Very short span of life. Then we should make it use of. Okay? Then. You are ready? Are you ready? Ready? Say, ready or not? Not yes. Nodding like this. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Inshallah, inshallah. Say,
inshallah.
Inshallah. Yes. Then, now, some more hadith regarding this subject. Sunan al-Nasa'i, hadith number 2470. Kitab al-Siyam, babu kaifa yasumu salatata ayyam min kulli shahr wa dhikri ikhtilafin naqilina lil khabri fi dhalik. Chapter, how to fast 3 days each month and mentioning the differences reported by the narrators in the narration regarding that. That is, narration regarding the 3 days of fasting every month. Then, and Hunayda ibn Khalid an imratihi an ba'd azwaj an-nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam anna rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam kana yasumu tis'an min dhil-hijja wa yawm ashura wa thalathat ayyam min kulli shahr afdal ithnayn min ash-shahr wa khamisayn. Hunayda bin Khalid report this hadith from his wife, and his wife report is from the one from one of the wives of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He said, she said, that is the wife of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, kana yasumu tis'an min dhil-hijja, he used to fast 9 days of dhil-hijja, that is from 1 to 9. Then wa yawm ashura, and the day of ashura. Ashura means muharram. Muharram 10th. Yes, pat muharram 10th. Then wa thalathat ayyam min kulli shahr, and every month 3 days. Which are the 3 days? Awwal ithnayn min ash-shahr, that is from the month, the first 2 days of hijra calendar, hijra month. Then wa khamisayn, awwal ithnayn, that is the first Monday. Awwal ithnayn means the first Monday of each month, the first Monday of each month. Wa khamisayn, and 2 Thursdays. So regarding this, there are different reports. In some report it is 13th, 14th and 15th of each month. That is Ayyamul Bidh. So regarding that, there are different reports. That is why the bab is given like this. The title of the bab is An-Naqilina. That is, وَذِكْرِ اخْتِلَافِ النَّاقِلِينَ لِلْخَبْرِ فِي ذَلِكَ. That is, the report, the differences reported by the narrators regarding this. So under that bab, this hadith is given. So another hadith also, other hadiths also are there under that bab. That is the title denotes. Okay. So sometimes Prophet, some people or some wives of prophets might have noticed like this, and some others might have noticed like that. So he might have observed fasting during 13th, 14th and 15th on one occasion, or on other occasion he might have done it like this, okay, yeah? Or both, there are chances, okay. So that's why the report varies, okay. Then another hadith, the next hadith 2418 Nasa'i itself. And Hunayda bin Khalid al-Khuzai and Hafsa qalat arba'un lam yakun yada'uhunna Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam siyamu ashura wal ashra wa thalathat ayyam min kulli shahr wa rak'atayn qabla al-qadat. Hafsa radiyallahu anha reports this hadith. So Hunayda bin Khalid, here also Hunayda is reporting the hadith from Hafsa radiyallahu anha, one of the wives of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hafsa bint Umar radiyallahu anhu. Okay, قالت, she said, أربعٌ لم يكن يدعهن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Four things, which the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم never used to avoid or abandon. He never abandoned four things he didn't give up. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Whose hadith? Who is reporting the hadith?
Hafsa.
Who is Hafsa? The wife of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the daughter of Khalifa Umar radiyallahu anhu. Okay. Arba'un lam yakun yada'uhunna Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam siyama ashura. Which are the four things? Siyama ashura. It is ashura, fasting. The 10th of Muharram. Wal ashur, and the 10 days fasting. That is, the 10 days means the first 10 days. That is, out of those 10 days, except the 10th day. Okay. It is 129. Then, وَثَلَاثَةَ أَيَّامٍ مِنْ كُلِّ شَهْرٍ. And in each month, 3 days. Which are they? 3 days. Here it is not mentioned in this hadith. Okay. وَرَكَعَتَيْنِ قَبَلِ الْغَدَاتِ. And 2 raka'ah before Fajr. So, before Fajr prayer, before Subh Salah. Subh Namaz, there is 2 raka'ah sunnah, nafil. So, that these 4 things Prophet never abandoned. Okay, he performed it usually. Okay, as an adat. Now, in Sunan Abi Dawood, one hadith is there. Kitabu Sawm, hadith number 2437. Babu fi Sawmil Ashur, regarding the fasting of 10 days. There also the same hadith that just we quoted. Similar. The last part is وثلاث أيام من كل شهر أول اثنين من الشهر والخميس. The 3 days of fasting each month, that is first Monday and then Thursday. Okay. Then Sunan Ibn Majah, one hadith is there, a different hadith. Kitab al-Siyam. عن الأسود عن عائشة قالت ما رأيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم صام أشهر قط. So Aisha's report. Aisha radiyallahu anha, another wife of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So she reports like this. I never saw the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fasting the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. I have never seen the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam observing the fasting of the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. So it seems it contradicts the hadith of Hafsa radiyallahu anha, another wife of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, as there are authentic hadiths, these two hadiths, that is, hadith of Hafsa radiyallahu anha, one wife of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the daughter of Umar radiyallahu anhu. Then, hadith of Aisha radiyallahu anha, wife of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the daughter of Abu Bakr radiyallahu anhu. And both reports are authentic, sahih. As there are authentic hadiths, from the mothers of believers. Who are the mothers of believers? The wives of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are called Ummahatul Mu'mineen, the mothers of believers. They are our mothers. They are respected, our mothers. Then, in which Hafsa radiyallahu anha, one of the wives of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said that he did never abandon the fasting of the 9 days of Dhul Hijjah. Then, in another report, that is Aisha radiyallahu anha, another wife of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say, she did never see Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam observing the fasting of the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. Okay, then these two reports, as there are these two types of reports, there are some minor difference of opinion among the scholars regarding this, whether it is sunnah or not to fast from 1 to 9. So regarding the 9th day's fasting, there are so many authentic hadiths. That is Arafah day's fasting. Okay. Then, the most prominent or the dominant, the important, the mashhoor, mukhtar view is that what? The fasting is sunnah. Fasting is sunnah. Because there are many hadiths regarding the virtues of the good deeds of the 10 days. So, 10 days. And we know out of those 10 days, the 10th day is Eid al-Adha. Then fasting is not permitted, it is prohibited. But other good deeds are okay. Then, you know, then 1 to 9, those days. Out of that 9th day fasting, that is Arafah fasting, there are many reports, many authentic reports. Then 1 to 8. So, you know, good deeds are virtuous on those days. There are many authentic reports. So, among the good deeds, it will include what? Fasting. Fasting also will be good deeds. Okay. One good deed. Fasting, one good deed. One type of good deeds. So, here the prominent view is that fasting is sunnah. Fasting is nafil during the from first day of Dhul Hijjah to 9th day of Dhul Hijjah. Okay. Out of the fasting, the Arafah day's fasting is more and important. Okay. Then. Now, what we see what Imam Baihaqi says regarding this contradicting or seemingly contradicting reports. قال البيهقي رحمه الله بعدما ذكر حديث حفصة رضي الله عنها وهذا الحديث أولى ما سبق ذكره من الحديث الذي روي عن عائشة أنها قالت ما رأيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم صائما في العشر قط لأن هذا مثبت فهو أولى من النافي فضائل الأوقات هي كتاب لبيهقي إمام بيهقي one kitab fadail al awqat, the virtues of times, periods, or awqat. Then the hadith of Hafsa radiyallahu anha is preferred more than the hadith of Aisha in this regard, because the first one is musbat, that is she did see it. Okay, her report is like that. But Hafsa Aisha's report, Aisha radiyallahu anha's report is in the negative sense, that is Nafi, Nafi, it is negation. So, when there is musbat regarding in a matter, then it will prevail more. Okay? There is a Nafi report. That means she didn't see. If we didn't see, it may not mean it is not there. Okay? Suppose, Munawwirah say, I haven't seen such a thing. That doesn't mean it is not there. Okay? Follow? And Mubashira see, I have seen such a thing. Then which one we can believe or we can rely upon? Mubashira's. Because she said she had seen. The other say, I haven't seen. Means, I have seen. May be there or may not be there. Okay. Now, Imam Nawawi rahmatullahi alayhi say in his Majmu' al-Fatawa, قال النبي رحمه الله قال العلماء هو متأول على أنها لم تره ولا يلزم منه تركه في نفس الأمر لأنه صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يكون عندها في يوم من تسعة أيام والباقي عند باقي أمهات المؤمنين رضي الله عنهن. Now, Imam Nawawi views is like this. That is, Aisha radiallahu anhu didn't see, it may not necessarily mean what he didn't observe fasting. Not meaning that No meaning like that. Because Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, out of this 9 days, 1, 2, 9, out of this 9 days, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam stayed or lived with Aisha or stayed in the house of Aisha only 1 day. He might have lived or stayed in the house of Aisha only 1 day. Because he has other wives too. He might have stayed other days, that is 8 days, in the house of other wives. So Aisha might have noticed it. Okay. He might have observed fasting. Aisha might have noticed the fast. So there is chance. أو لعله صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يصوم بعضه في بعض الأوقات وكله في بعضها ويتركه في بعضها لعار السفر أو مرض أو غيرهما وبهذا إجماع بين الحديث أحاديث. No. Also there is possibility. نبي صلى الله عليه وسلم might have fasted some days at some occasions. Okay. And full 9 days at some other occasions. Okay. Also, sometimes he might have avoided fasting due to illness. Okay. Or travel or the like. Good. What the point? No. In Sharah Muslim also, Imam Nawawi records the same similar view. Imam Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah also said, the hadith of Hafsa, which is Musbat, is preferred over the latter in this regard. In his Zadul Ma'ad, one kitab. Zadul Ma'ad fi Huda Khairil Ibad, one kitab. Then, Imam Shawkani is also expressing the same or similar view in his Nailul Awtar. Nailul Awtar. Nailul Awtar fi Sharahi Muntaqal Akhbar, Shawkani. Now, in Tirmidhi, one hadith is there. It is hadith number 757. 757. Kitabu Sawmi an Rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Babu ma ja'a fil amali fi ayyam al ashr. What has been related about the deeds, good deeds, during the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. Under that bab. The same hadith we have discussed earlier, actually. So we are skipping it. Then, in Tuhfat al-Wardi, Tuhfat al-Ahwadi, the Sharah of Sunani Jami al-Tirmidhi. Jami al-Tirmidhi. So Jami al-Tirmidhi, hadith number 757. For that hadith, explanation is given in Tuhfatul Ahwadi. One kitab. Tuhfatul Ahwadi. And there, they say, وَقَالَ بَعْضُهُمْ أَشْرُ رَمَضَانَ أَفْضَلُ لِلصَّوْمِ وَالْقَدْرِ وَالْمُخْتَارُ أَنَّ أَيَّامَ هَذِهِ الْأَشْرُ أَفْضَلُ لِيَوْمِ عَرَفَةَ وَلَيَالِي أَشْرِ رَمَضَانَ أفضل ليلة القدر لأن يوم عرفة أفضل أيام السنة وليلة القدر أفضل ليالي السنة ولذا قال ما من أيام ولم يقل ما من ليالي كذا في الأزهار وكذا في الميقات. But there are discussions as to which 10 days good deeds are better. The last 10 days of Ramadan or the last the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, which is better? There are discussions. Now some say Ashur Ramadan, afdal li sawm. The last 10 days of Ramadan fasting is better. Okay. Wal qadr. Then, wal mukhtar. Anna ayyama hadhihi al-ashr afdal li yawmi arafa. No. The selected view or the mukhtar or the prominent view is that. What? The preferred view is that. As far as the days or day times are concerned, the day times of the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah are better. As far as the day times are concerned, day times, Nahar is concerned, the good deeds of day times of the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah are better. Because Arafah day is there. And we know Arafah day is the best day among all days of the whole year. Okay. And as far as night is concerned, night time is concerned, the 10 nights, the last 10 nights of Ramadan is better as far as night is concerned. So regarding day, the last, the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, day times are better. Okay. Than all other day times. Because there is Arafah. Arafah, as we know, it is the most important, afdal, or most virtuous day time. Throughout the whole year. If we take the whole year, Arafah days, day time is the best. Okay, the best time. And like that, you know, Laylatul Qadr falls in the month of Ramadan. And it is expected in the last 10 nights. So Laylatul Qadr falls in the last 10 nights of the Ramadan. Okay. So as far as night is concerned, the last 10 nights of Ramadan is better than all other nights. Okay. Because Laylatul Qadr is the best night among all other nights of the whole year. And that's why Prophet said, وَلِذَا قَالَ مَا مِنْ أَيَّامٍ. There are no days, nahar. يوم means day, also day time. Okay, يوم. مَا مِنْ أَيَّامٍ وَلَمْ يَقُنْ مِنْ لَيَعْلِ. And he didn't say, Prophet didn't say, there are no nights. So nights, there are more virtuous nights during the Ramadan. Okay. And it is there in Azhar and in Miqat. Imam Nawawi said. In Tuhfat al-Ahwadi, it records like this. Now Hadith 758. Tirmidhi. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and Abu Hurairah, and in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ma min ayyamin ahabbu ila Allahi ayyuta'abbada lahu fiha min ashri dhil hijjah. Ya'udil siyamu kulli yawmin minha bis siyamu sana. وقيام كل ليله منها بقيام ليله القدر. اوكي السلام عليكم.